It's amazing by this capacity crowd.
More like the Odd Couple to me. He's got two dogs out there, not just one. He's got two dogs to walk tonight before he goes back to the hotel or wherever the heck, but Lonnie's gone.
Oh, look at this!
No, no! His hands are being chased up by that butt! That dog should not be allowed to ring!
But Tilda's going to the last ring. Angle, and he took off like a shot. Boy, she knows.
I've been chased by that butt, you know, Monsoon. That flea-infested mutt chased me one time. I know how this man feels. Humiliated in front of these people by that scroungy mutt.
Oh, she's going after him again. I wish she'd take a chunk out of Danny Davis.
That's unbelievable. You wish he would do what, Monsoon? Take a chunk out of Danny Davis?
Absolutely. That's who deserves it. Danny Davis, there she goes again.
Look at that butt. I don't blame these guys. Say what you want. That dog could have some kind of distemper or something. Who knows? Get that dog out of here.
20,000 plus enjoying every moment of it here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. And the hitman saying, yeah, let me give me a shot. Let me put the boots to him.
Nobody's enjoying it more than you, Monsoon. I saw that smile on your face after that dog went after that poor Anvil Neidhart. And then you start talking about Danny Davis being bitten. That's sick.
Well, did my eyes deceive me or did I not see you standing and applauding when Danny Davis was...
I happen to admire the young career of this Danny Davis. It's men like him that this country was based upon. The men with the guts to make decisions in life. That's what I like, people like him.
Well, Danny Davis has come under so much scrutiny here in the past several months in the World Wrestling Federation that it wouldn't surprise me if we don't see too much more of him in the very near future. Where is the Colonel?
Well, I guess you're referring to Colonel Jimmy Hart.
Absolutely.
Well, from what I understand, Colonel Jimmy Hart, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and Mr. Fuji are in a meeting, and there's big time talk going around between these three men.
Please.
I understand they are having dinner in New York City at this very moment, discussing some upcoming matches. You understand? So there. You want to know? I'll tell you.
The three of those guys together couldn't get locked up.
Oh boy. 2,000 comedians out of work up there, huh? Gonna have this half wit next to me.
Davey Boy starting out here, it looks like, with the hitman. No, look at the anvil. He says, I want to start. Please, let me start. You know, we're not gonna have a match here between the anvil and the hitman.
No, 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 they're very close. They're very close friends. And that they're also a very awesome and devastating team. The Hart Foundation is a great team.
There's no question about that.
Could be champions any night. Any given night, any given month, any given year, these guys could win titles.
Something that has eluded you and your dream team.
Oh, you're gonna get it. You know, you're gonna get it. Really cruising, pal.
The hitman complaining about something. Maybe you should go up there and manage these guys, John.
Well, you're
right at home doing that.
I very well may here. You never know what I'm gonna do. As long as that butt's out of here, I may have to lend a helping hand here as far as the brains here, as far as interjecting of something.
Look at that.
You see that JYD standing outside that ring out there? There's a man at six. He's a sick man, that JYD. These people love him. I admire him. I don't know why.
Complaining about a hair pull when in fact it was obvious that there wasn't any. Got about 47 pounds of Brill Cream on his head.
Who's that?
The hitman.
Wow, a little devil, do you, they say.
Look at Davis now getting on the case.
That's good.
Of Davey Boy. He never touched the guy's head.
Sure he did. What's the matter with you? From where I see it, that's exactly what happened. You tell him, Danny Davis. You tell him.
Front face lock by the hitman. Davey Boy tried to pick him right up, but it's awful hard to do from that position.
Now,
there's the power of Davey Boy. sits him right up on that top turn. Oh, look at that.
Oh, man.
Talk about insult.
That is the height in pro wrestling of embarrassing your opponent, slapping him in a kisser. As if to say, you know.
Tag made as the Anvil steps in. I thought the Hitman would be very upset.
He was upset.
So upset that he went right over and tagged.
Yeah, he'll get even with this limey pretty soon. Look at this also. Do you see where he's intimidated that Mr. Neidhart?
Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the powerhouse.
Ooh, is he ever.
On his heart foundation.
Cornerstone.
Look at that. Ooh, nobody awesome. Punched. Oh, he's laughing right in the face of Davey Boy.
Says, do it again if you want.
He made him take a couple of steps back, but nothing serious.
How strong's this guy now, Monsoon? Uh-oh, stalemate.
The irresistible force meeting the immovable object here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. Oh, nice single leg kick. Takes more than brute strength. It takes brains, Johnny V.
Well, that's something that this Limey doesn't have, so I can predict a victory here for the Hart Foundation. Danny Davis telling JYD to make sure you stay there and wait for the bus, pal.
Davis breaking the hold out because
he should have broke that hold up, which was very good.
Reached the bottom rope.
Nothing gets by Danny Davis, Marshall.
What's the problem now? Why is he stopping the match?
Because the guy has some equipment malfunctions there.
There is no timeout in the world of professional wrestling.
Well, I think his shoelace was undone. All right, now we're back to the action.
Look at the dog waiting with bated breath to get into this matchup.
Yeah, he's got some breath, all right. See,
pulling what hair?
No. I can see it right now. This guy was pulling his hair, Neidhart's telling Danny Davis. And that's exactly what happened. He's telling him, stay off the man's hair.
The Anvil doesn't have any hair, John.
Well, he's got enough. Well, maybe he said stay off his goatee.
There's the tag made.
Here comes your buddy.
JYD stepping in. Oh, listen to him. He goes a mile a minute.
Yep.
Once he's inside that ring, he's talking up a storm.
Sure is. He's jiving all the time, isn't he?
Oh, he tried to pull a dog's hair. I love
that. There's nothing up there, inside or out. Oh, man. We got a big chunk of that Jim the Anvil Neidhart's goatee. Get on him, Danny Davis.
Things not going too well at this particular point in time for the Hart Foundation.
Well, all they're doing is stirring these guys up.
Look out, wide open. And the dog's out of the way, and the Hitman goes sprawling onto the runway here. Oh, look at this.
Ooh, Anvil says.
Why is Danny Davis warning Junkyard Dog? For what reason?
He's been pulling hair because he's been hitting with a clenched fist. He's been pulling trunks.
Because he's stupid.
Oh, boy. He's stupid, huh? If he's stupid, I'm Frank Nitti's grandmother. Hey, listen, let me tell you something. You stick to the action here. Don't be so biased.
I like to call him as I see them go down, Johnny V.
Well, and you better do it because you haven't been doing it so far.
Back into the corner now.
Notice JYD stayed away from the corner of Jimmy of Bret Hart over there.
Oh, look at Danny Davis putting his hands on the Junkyard Dog. I don't believe that. Give me a break.
He lost his balance there, JYD.
Lost his balance. The guy had him hooked. The referee hooked his arm.
Did he? I kind of thought he lost his balance. Oh. Now that's the kind of counts I like. Nice and fast. One, two, three.
Supposed to be a 1 second between counts. There was none there.
I thought there was 1 second. I thought it was 2 seconds.
Dog's in trouble.
He's in the wrong quarter.
Here in Toronto is the Hart Foundation, a master of deceit. That's a mistake.
He's gonna do his homework.
He didn't do his homework.
The punch didn't affect him at all.
Champ going on from this capacity crowd, JYD. He's trapped now in the wrong corner.
Get in there, Anvil, if you can, help him.
He's trying to get out there. Danny Davis quick to lay the count on the Davey Boy. And there was no ducking out of the way of that one. Tiger's made.
You got two of those guys in the ring at one time. JYD and what do you call it? Davey Boy.
Nobody there to count.
That's it. That's the way. Move them back. Ooh. What a big sledgehammer from Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
That's right, Danny. After the damage is done, go over there and tell the guy to stay out.
He's doing his job. No, come on. He warned him.
Inverted atomic drop laid on Davey Boy Smith. And now he's in trouble.
Now he puts back JYD. He's keeping law and order.
Sure.
Making sure it's done here.
There goes Davey Boy right out onto the ramp. Oh, look at that. Give me a break.
Wow.
The hitman went over there and threw himself down to distract Danny Davis, making him think that the junkyard dog had done something to him. In the meantime, they're going to work on Davey Boy.
Danny Davis is telling this man here, JYD,
who did absolutely nothing.
He's telling him to make sure you stay in your corner like you're supposed to and hold on to the rope.
Danny Davis doesn't need anybody to make a fool out of him. He can make a fool out of himself.
Says you, brother. Ooh, picked him right up by his wig.
Can't even keep his shirt in his pants. The Anvil doing the number right now on Davey Boy. Ducks underneath that. Oh, look at that.
Move.
Where was Davis looking then?
Well, he tripped. This Englishman tripped on the turnbuckle there, on the apron somehow.
Another quick two count.
Boy, this is some team here, this Hart Foundation. One compliments the other.
Davey Boy needing desperately to make a tag here. Oh, look at that, nice crucifix. What's Danny Davis doing? Why isn't he counting?
Because Neidhart's not back in the corner.
Oh, look at that. Would you see the difference in that count?
No, I don't understand what your problem is here.
Hey.
He's gonna make sure he's in the corner. Bret Hart on top of the situation here.
18 or 20,000 plus here in Toronto know exactly what I'm talking about. However, you, who've been around the game of professional wrestling for over 15 years, do not.
Well, I'll tell you what, I call it as it is, and there's nothing there that I don't agree with.
You better have your prescription changed.
Well, I may. I very well may have a prescription changed.
This capacity crowd expressing my sentiments exactly.
What are they saying out there? That's what I thought they were saying.
Yes.
Bearhart. The barnyard animals problems. Okay, back to the action here, baby. Jim the Anvil Neidhart with that bear hug on the Englishman. Of course, you know it's Davey Boy Smith. JYD offering some encouragement, but it's to no avail. Get it back, Danny Davis. Very good. I've heard the term of losing your shirt in a match, but Danny Davis is about to very well do that.
Huh. I said that earlier on. He doesn't even look like a referee.
Oh, he is. I give him a lot of credit.
Look at this, turning his back on the action now to give the hitman an opportunity to come in. There was no tag made. If you don't see a tag, you're not supposed to allow it.
Well, that's what they said. Oh, what an uppercut by Bret Hart.
Irish whipman, look at
Man.
Backdrop.
That'll bring rain.
Almost a three count as Danny Davis didn't waste any time getting down there.
What an uppercut. Englishman in trouble. Bret Hart could be putting him away here any minute.
Sleeper hold right in the center of the ring.
Danny Davis asking that Limey. Oh, come on. Give it up there, you. Give it up, you fish and chipper, you.
Davey Boy definitely not a quitter. Look at this. He's right underneath the chin there. That's a choke hold. That's a deliberate choke hold.
You see from this angle what's going on there.
You got reach your hand under there and take a look.
That is a legitimate sleeper hold. Nothing to do with a choke hold.
He's being definitely choked out here.
Nah,
that forearm is right underneath the chin. But Davey Boy is fighting this thing.
fight
as he will have to do, because he's not going to get any assistance from Danny Davis. Look at his power display. Oh, rams him right into the corner.
Both men are down here momentarily, but I think that Bret Hart suffered the least of that injury.
Davey, with an opportunity to make a tag, he better do it.
He's a tough man out there, that Bret Hart.
Reversal as the Hitman goes in.
Whoa!
Oh, look at this press slam.
Oh my lord! Did you see what happened there, Monsoon? Oh! I think Bret Hart's voice is going to be so high, he'll be able to sing with Pavarotti after this one.
Look at Davey trying to get over there to make the tag, as the Hitman is definitely in trouble.
He'll be the king of the high seas.
And the Dog is anxious to get in there. There's the tag. And here comes the Anvil. He's not legal in the ring. Look at Danny Davis. What's he doing?
He's staying out of the way. Just like I would do. That's what he's doing. He's doing nothing. Saying, come here, baby. Come here, baby.
He's doing nothing, Johnny.
Well,
absolutely
he's doing
nothing.
I agree with you there.
Double knocker coming up.
Oh, I heard of the head-to-head. Now that's heart-to-heart.
And there goes the Anvil out onto the runway.
It's just Bret Hart and JYD now.
The Hitman in a whole lot of trouble here in Toronto. Perhaps the power slam.
Oh, yeah.
He nailed him with it. Down for the count. Oh, the Anvil came in out of nowhere.
Nice piece of work.
And Davey Boy on his case immediately. All four men inside the ring right now.
That away, Neidhart. Get rid of that lining. Small package here by Bret Hart. JYD is down. Hey, wait a minute. Did you see that?
Oh, look at
that. Hey! That Danny Boy Smith turned the guy over. That's illegal. What about that one, Monsoon?
Well, Danny
Boy. Where are you, Monsoon?
Danny
Davis,
in fact, thought that it was the Anvil who was putting the pinning combination on the JYD, and it was the other way around.
I never heard
of your winners, the team of Davey Boy Smith and Junkyard Dog.
Danny Davis made a big mistake here, which really worked to the advantage.
I'll tell you something, Monsoon. Wait a minute. Wait a second here. What's he saying?
Danny Davis, look at Matilda. She's going after everybody.
He's doing what?
Matilda cleaned house with everybody. I love it.
I wish the people would write in here and get this dog. That animal has no way of blowing around the ring.
Boy, Danny Davis really made a big blunder here, as he thought he was giving the edge to the Hart Foundation, when in fact he gave the victory to the Junkyard Dog and Davey Boy Smith.
Boy, I'll tell you, Monsoon, highway robbery here. Total highway robbery, the way JV sees it here.
This capacity crowd in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens really enjoying every minute of this tag match, despite the antics of Danny Davis. What's the dog up to?
Look at him strutting around there like, what is he, some kind of a rooster in the barnyard walking around there?
He's obviously got something in mind.
Yeah.
I know you guys might think I'm Jimmy Hendrix or somebody, but I want some of those fine little kids to come on right here on the floor and get down with the dog and let's do it some more.
Oh, he's asking for some youngsters to come up here and do some juking with the dog.
Some juking or puking.
He'll get plenty of volunteers in a hurry.
Oh, why don't you get in there, Monsoon? Oh, look at this here.
He's got all kinds coming in now.
This looks like giveaway day at Macy's.
The ring is being filled right now with youngsters.
I'll hold your microphone if you want to get in.
Congratulating the Junkyard Dog.
This is unbelievable here, man.
It's bedlam here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens.